League Baseball on the show for you now as we present coverage from the AAA East. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the Rochester Red Wings and the Scranton Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Victor Robles digging in now, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 2-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number two. Should be a picture perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. Ball three. 3-2 now. Jeremy De La Rosa will be next. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. Next it'll be Jeremy De La Rosa. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two. Now at the plate, Rhett Wiseman. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. So now here is Tim LoCastro. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. One and one, here it comes. Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Lays off, 2-2 now.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
He got three balls and two strikes.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And that's out number one. Next to stand in is Andrew Velasquez.
Number 71.
Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
Hey.
2-2. One out, nobody on. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Chris Gittens will be next. Lifted the other way out to left center. Giving chase is Robles. He gets there, and that's the second out. Ready now is Chris Gittens. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. The 2-1 home. On the screws to shortstop, but caught to retire the side. Now it'll be Drew Mendoza. He'll get us started in the top of the second. The 1-1. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw is in time for the first out of the second. So one out, nobody aboard. And here is the outfielder, Mike Ford. And this pitch is taken high and away to fill the count. It's 3-2. Jackson Flores waits on deck. High in the air down the right field line. Florial is there. Two down. Up next, Jackson Flores. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Hit in the air to shallow center. Hicks is under it. And that ends the inning. Bottom bottom of the inning now, and standing in the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Now the 1-1 pitch. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Now a curveball here. Nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1. Aaron Hicks will be next. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. Next to hit, Aaron Hicks. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. The 2-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder coming on. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Into the box, Estevan Florio.
The right fielder.
Frazier, base runner at first with one out.
Florio.
Lifted down the line in left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. The 1-2 is a breaking ball that's taken for a ball.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Swing and a miss on the breaking pitch. Two away. And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Hot shot on the ground is short. He's got it, and he'll go the short way to retire the shot. Striding forward now is the DH, number 88, 789, bottom of the order set to go here in the third. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Batting eight.
At the plate now is Samuel Infante. The 1-1 home.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Ready with the 1-2. It looked like the fastball got away from him there. Full count, 3-2. Number 38 will be next. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Now to bat, number 38. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. The 1-1. And struck him out. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Victor Robles. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Two balls and a strike to count. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. Here's a pop-up now. LoCastro is there, and the side is retired. So here is Mandy Alvarez as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. set. Here comes the 1-1. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. Fouled off. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. So next to hit is Rob Brantley. His past numbers with Steven Strasburg. He's just 2-for-9. He also has one home run. Fouled away. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. A ball hit hard to the left side. And there's their first hit of the game.
The batter, the second baseman, Tim LoCastro.
Into the box, Tim LoCastro. 1-2 now as that's in there at the knees.
Hey, I don't blame him for giving up on that curveball. That was a rainbow coming out of the sky. Stole a strike.
A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Number 71.
And now here is Andrew Velasquez. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. The 1-1 home.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Again, a 1-2. Now a breaking ball runs in on him as he's got to get his hands out of the way on that pitch. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Jeremy De La Rosa.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And he got him. Next to dig in, Rhett Wiseman struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch AVs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
From the stretch. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away.
Now batter.
Here's Mike Ford.
Mike Ford.
Right down the chute that time. 1-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And another foul ball. The 1-2 pitch. In the dirt, and now let's see. In time, and he is nailed at second. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And here comes the first baseman, Chris Gittens. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Clint Frazier. Worked a walk his first time up. Bases are empty, one man out. That nibbled the corner there, but missed, 2-1. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down. And now Aaron Hicks flew out in his only at bat so far. Two balls and a strike. Here it is.
That's a ball.
Plays off the breaking pitch, and it's three balls and a strike.
Three balls, one strike.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
And it's fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes to an end. Stepping up is Mike Ford. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Fouled off. Fouled away. Here's another 1-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1.
Well, this next pitch is a big one. The last thing you want to do is give a free pass to a guy that can run like this. He's a real burner out there on the base paths.
Frazier is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. Next will be the designated hitter, number 88. He drew a base on balls his first time up. High in the air down the right field line. He's under it, and that ends the inning. And stepping in, Esteban Florial comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Here now the 2-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. So bases are empty with one gone, and striding into the plate, it'll be Miguel Andujar. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two, swinging.
Man, this has been a game filled of a lot of swings and misses. Not very many confident swings, and this team up there, they'd swing at a butterfly right now if it flew in front of the plate. Lots of swings, lots of misses, a lot of ugly at-bats for this team right now.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitch his second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Andujar is retired, two down now. So next to bat will be Mandy Alvarez. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Now at the plate, here is Samuel Infante. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. 1-1. He's swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Not a spot you'd expect a curveball. He's lucky he missed, because that's the kind of pitch that gets hit out of the ballpark.
Got him.
And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame. Next, it'll be number 38. 0 for 1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the 2 strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
High in the air down the right field line. And it's a foul ball. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hicks is under it, and he makes the catch for the second out. Next, here is Victor Robles. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper head.
Well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. Bottom of the 6th inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Rob Brantley. The 2-1. Strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Now back,
to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Tim LoCastro. He's grounded out and struck out in his 2 trips to the plate. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. To send him packing for the second time.
Account full.
On the ground to third, right to him. On to first, and Strasburg's in control here, 2 away. Next to hit is Andrew Velasquez, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanics when he's hitting left-handed. He dropped that curveball in for a strike right there, but don't kid yourself, that's a dangerous pitch. He needs to start thinking about maybe working that back door, or that could get some serious damage done to it.
Next up, Chris Gittens. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And this ball runs away for ball 2. 2-1. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag. Big spot here. First and second. 2 men gone. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. The 2-2. Velasquez on second. Gittens on at first with 2 down. And he fouls this one off. He's set. The 2-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Popped him up. Right fielder coming on. And he brings it down to end the inning as the go-ahead run is left stranded. Seventh inning ready to roll, and digging in is the outfielder, Jeremy De La Rosa. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. And it's fouled away. Up. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Fielded cleanly. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Stepping in next, Rhett Wiseman. It was a walk in his last trip. Pulled toward right center field. After it is Hicks. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Digging in will be Drew Mendoza. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. 2-2. Now a swing and another fly ball here as things are getting busy out there in Central. Hicks able to track it down for the third out. Patrick Murphy will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 52.
So stepping in is Aaron Hicks, 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. Struck him out, so he set down on strikes for the second time today. And that'll bring in Esteban Florial, 0-for-2 for him to this point. 3-2 pitch. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Now that
here's Miguel Andujar now. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Grounded to the right. Reined in. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Mike Ford. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Saw his eyes light up that time, but he swung at a bad one there.
He's up to 100 pitches now, but he's still bringing the fastball pretty good. Nothing about that last throw tells me he's wearing down right now.
Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. So now to the plate, Jackson Flores, 0-for-2, he's flown out twice. And that one misses badly, it's ball 2. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now to the plate. Number 88 flew out last time up. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. Scooped up. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Stepping in once again is Mandy Alvarez, 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. The 1-2. It swung on and missed, strike 3. Digging in next, Rob Brantley. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get
completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order.
Now this will rattle up against the wall. And he is in the second base with one away as the go-ahead run.
Now back, second baseman, Tim LoCastro.
At the plate, Tim LoCastro takes this the other way to right. That's in there, base hit. Second now with one away. Stepping in now, Andrew Velasquez. Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2. Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here now the 2-2. Hit out towards second. And that'll get past his outstretched glove. It's a base hit. The runner from third crosses the plate, and they've taken a 1-0 lead. In now, Chris Gittens. And he takes a look at strike three called, and that's as important as they come there. Two big outs now.
No left fielder.
Here's the 1-1.
He's not having his best outing in this one, and I think that curveball is part of the reason why. He couldn't get on top of that one, and that's not the first time that's happened.
And he has delivered one of the biggest at-bats of the afternoon as he cashes in with a base hit. Aaron Barrett drops in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. To the plate now, Aaron Hicks. Belted high and deep into right center. Right fielder looking up, still ranging back. And goodbye, this one ain't coming back. So now to the plate, Esteban Florial. No offer on that one, 2 balls and a strike. They set up away with the fastball, but it misses 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes to right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back-to-back home runs. Into the box, Miguel Andujar. 2-2 pitch is fouled away. Two out, nobody on. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Line drive, that's a base hit into the right center field gap. Luis Avilan comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one.
Alvarez.
At the plate now, Mandy Alvarez. A ball and two strikes now.
1-2.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Michael King comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 73, Michael.
Now to the plate, here is Samuel Infante, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Now the 2-1. Sent on the ground out the second. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Now with the plate is number 38. 0 for 2 on his line thus far. One out, nobody on. And this one runs a little too far in. Ball two. He's falling behind now. 3-1.
One thing that can nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise right through. He's not known for his offensive prowess, but he's putting together a real nice at bat here.
The bouncer to the left side. On the first, and they're an out away. Two gone here in the ninth. Next up is Victor Robles. He is the last man to stand in the way of possible history here this afternoon. And he rolls over this one. Foul. We'll do it once more. 3-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Swing and a miss, and he's got it. A no-hitter.
Yeah, you know what's amazing? A combined no-hitter is even more rare than a complete game no-hitter. So it's not something you see every day or every year for that matter. And that's what you call a total team effort.
Fans, our final line score. First for the victorious Rail Riders, 6 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Red Wings, no runs on no hits, 1 error. They left 2 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 51 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.